What is infinity? There's different definitions of infinity that have been proposed. It's a mathematical and philosophical jungle that you end up in if you're not clear about the fundamental notions from the start. Well, infinity is just fascinating. The problem is inherently attractive, and the questions that are so simple to ask, yet the analysis of them is so subtle. My favorite situation occurs when a question in philosophy gives rise to a kind of mathematical analysis, whose resolution then raises additional philosophical questions or refinements of the philosophical issues in a kind of feedback cycle. Maybe one example of that cycle between mathematics and philosophy is my work on potentialism. Is it inevitable if you're a potentialist? Is it inevitable what happens as you get more and more? Or is there some kind of possibility that might be different depending on how things unfold? So maybe you have part of the universe, and if you wait into one future or into another, then this sort of radical branching hypothesis gives rise to a totally different modal theory. There's currently raging a debate in the philosophy of set theory. So the question really at its core is there only one mathematical reality, or is there a kind of indefiniteness to mathematical questions? I've been a strong defender of set theoretic pluralism, and I'm defending the view that we have more than one concept of set, and that when we ask a question about set theory, there won't necessarily be a determinate answer. And part of the evidence for this view is exactly this experience that set theorists have had exploring all of these different set theoretic worlds. But recently I have several projects on potentialism. The topic is exploding. I've been looking at arithmetic potentialism, and with some other students, I'm looking at modal model theory, where we're looking at graph theoretic potentialism and potentialism with respect to other mathematical ideas. For example, if you have a graph that's a bunch of dots connected by edges, then ordinarily, in the language of graph theory, you can't express the two-colorability of a graph, the possibility of coloring the vertices with, say, red and blue. But in the modal language, it actually is expressible, two-colorability. And so we're looking at how expressive is the modal language, the potentialist language of graph theory. It's wonderful at Notre Dame. I'm so happy to be here because there's such a strong logic group in both philosophy and in mathematics. And the students are just fantastic to work with. I really hope to show them the beauty in the subject that I see, and that's the main thing.